It is, I think, already considered an older palette, but I don't care. I thought I had a plan. We'll start with the shade called Another. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I am playing with the Club Nebula palette from Kaleidos in collaboration with Angelica Nykvist. Yes, I have done 4 looks in total with this palette because I also did a first impression. And in the first impression, I was like, it was a get ready with me. I was just like, I love it so much. I want to create more looks, even though it is an older palette. I know it's not an old palette, but in the YouTube realm where things go very, very quickly, it is, I think, already considered an older palette. But I don't care because I love it so, so much that I really wanted to play with it. So yeah, I created 3 looks. I actually went row by row this time because I thought it would be fun. And I know that she kind of created the color stories like that as well. So you can go row by row, but you can mix and match if you want to. And you can go monochromatic. That's it. You can do so much with this palette. So yeah, 3 looks or 4 looks in total I created. I think they're going to restock it again in March, if I am not mistaken. So yeah, timestamps, if I don't forget that is. I will leave timestamps down below in the description box for the different looks. And for now, just grab a drink and a snack. Put your feet up and enjoy. Because here comes look number 1. Where's that hair? Oh. Look 1 with the Kaleidos and Angelica collab. And I have decided to go row by row because I think that the color stories are fun. And I actually don't know if people have done that before, because to be honest with you, I haven't watched any videos about it. So yeah, look number 1 is going to be row number 1. I'm going to start with the color 7 of 9. I thought I had a plan, but yeah. I have already primed my eyes, but I am experimenting. So it's not specifically an eye primer I'm using, it's actually in a concealer. So, and the concealers that I have, I mixed 2 concealers from Fenty. They kind of dry down on their own a little bit, and they are a little bit more dry, but they are olive. So I mixed the shades 290 and 145, and 145 is a little bit more here, because I kind of want to experiment a little bit with that, because the Natasha Denona base has kind of a concealer feel. But also not really. I kind of, yeah. The fun fact though is that now the shadows are largely true to pan, which is kind of fun. Next, I am going to go to the shade. Let's go to Queen of Blades, the dark teal. Okay, back to the first brush. I'm just going to blend that shade 7 of 9, the first teal, a little bit more back. Yeah, and here I can see the difference between the concealer and an eye base. That was the experiment, so. I'm back to the shade Queen of Blades with this brush because it's a little bit more fluffy. I'm just stepping it over the border here because that saves me blending. I'm going to go to the shade called Void, this one, and I'm going to follow my bottom lid up and stamp, well, basically create a line that I can follow. So I'm just looking forward with my eyes relaxed, preferably without any cat hair. And then I'm just following my bottom lid up to meet up with where I place the shadow. And I don't want to go past that. I just want that when my eyes are relaxed and I'm looking forward, that it has a nice flow. So I do want to kind of clean up here a bit. Basically, I'm ignoring all the folds that my eyes have right now. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to turn the brush. I'm basically going to bring it in so that I create kind of an eyeshadow wing. And then I'm going to flip it up, or flick it up. So I need a different brush for that. So it's a very flimsy brush, but I'm going lightly in that color void, tapping off my brush, and I'm just basically following that line in. So I'm starting there and then I'm flicking it in. And now I'm also basically filling in any gaps. That's at least the idea. The reason I'm grabbing this brush, because I don't really want the look to turn blue. I want to keep it a little bit more teal. But I do want to use the shadow and create some extra depth. I really like this. I do want to make sure that it is filled in properly though. I'm just going to grab a brush and the shade Void. And then when I look down, you can kind of see all the gaps. I'm just going to stamp a bit of color there. But not going outside, but I'm going in. I'm going to go into shade Gravity. And I'm going to stamp it on my lower lash line. Really packing it on. There's no primer there, no nothing, so I really wanted to show up, and it could be that I need to redo that, but that's okay. And then here I'm going to blend a bit, go a little bit in that shade Void, tiny bit, tap off, and then just blend it a bit. I quite like that. I'm just going to clean up my lid and see what happens actually. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the Fenty concealer that I use, but the lightest shade, and the brush, and I'm going to clean up my lid. Let's get you because you're a bit bigger. So you could say I'm doing a cut crease, because that's also done with the concealer. But I just kind of want to clean up the lid a little bit. And then here I'm going to tap. I'm actually going to tap all over. Just to make sure that I don't have weird build-ups. I'm going to grab the shade called Firefly. Let's put it on dry first. Let's just press it on. Oh, it's so pretty. Now again, this is a concealer, not a glitter primer. And this is more of a topper shade. But as you can see, it works very, very well. Let's spray it because I'm curious what happens then. So I'm picking up, I'm actually loading up my brush and then I'm spraying my brush. So I'm not going to go into the shadow with a wet brush and I'm just going to place it here. I kind of like it that it is a little bit sheer. And I want a little bit of 7 of 9. First shade I used just in the inner corner, so that it makes it a little bit lighter. I also want that shade Firefly on my lower lash line, but I am going to grab a little bit of glitter primer for that, just to make sure that it sticks nicely. I'm actually not using a lot of glitter primer right now, because I'm experimenting with that as well. We're going to go into some, I'm just going to press it on that matte shadow. So the shade Firefly is going to be tapped on top. Oh, that gives it a very, very nice greeny. Let's go back to the shade Gravity, which is the green matte. Just make sure that that green really pops. I like this. Now for pencil. So I don't really have the green that I have on my lower lash line, but I think this could be fun. So this is Chartreuse something from NYX. Cool, I think this is the eye look so far. So I'm going to finish everything off. Liner, lashes, the works. And then I will be back to show you the finished off look. I feel like Firefly. Or Peacock. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. I like it. I like how it turned out. Falsies are from Essence. The Lash Like a Boss falsies in the style Oh My God. And truly, especially for Essence. They're very nice and light and long and fluffy, and I like them. So yeah, the lippy is a combination between a Max & More lip pencil in the shade Muffin and a Catrice Clean ID Silk Intense lipstick in the shade Nude Blush. I swatched them here on my hand. So here you have the pencil and here you have the lipstick. So it's basically a darker orangey brownish something or another, but yeah, very pretty, very comfortable formula. Let me know what you think of it and let's get ready for look number two. Hello, look two is going to be row two. I've already primed my eyes. Yeah, I don't think it's going to be very complicated though. I'm just going to start with the shade called Naru. I'm just going to lightly set. Okay, I was going to say lightly set, but it's more pigmented than I expected. Or actually, the color is a little bit darker than I expected. That's what I want to say. It is a nice color though, and it's a color that I would very much enjoy. So I'm going to go next to the shade called Rockhopper. It's going to go in the inner and outer corner. I think the birds know that it is the first day. It's the spring equinox today as I'm filming this, which is the 20th of March on Saturday. And the birds know it. You know, you can just, I don't know, I can just tell that spring is in the air, even though it is very, very cold outside. And it has actually frozen a little bit here during the night. Let's get a slightly denser brush and then in the same color to deepen it up a little bit before I go in with the darkest color. And I do like to lightly connect. Now I'm going to go to the color called Cylon. And I'm going to deepen up the inner and outer corner even more. But I'm going to keep it very, very much on the outside. And even though I'm doing kind of a halo eye, I still want to keep the shape flattering for my eye shape. I'm going to go back to the first shade called Naru to blend everything out, or at least the top edges. I actually think I'm going to take a little bit of the shade Void, the dark blue, because I want it a little bit deeper. I'm going to go to an even smaller brush and just really concentrate this on the inner and outer eye part area. Back to the shade Cylon. I'm going to put it on top because I don't want it blue. Okay, it always looks like a mess, always. Shimmer time. Well, it's not really weird what I'm going to do shimmer wise. I think I'm going to start with the shade called Astro. We were thinking I was going to put it in the center, weren't you? Well, actually, I was thinking that too, but apparently I'm not. So next I'm going to go to the shade You're My Only Hope. I actually want to put a little bit of glitter primer on first. Just a tiny bit. I don't really think that the shade's needed, but I just want a little bit of extra stickiness today because I'm going to play in the woods in an hour. And I want to look fabulous. I'm just tapping it there where I want the shade You're My Only Hope. Oh yeah, like this. Okay, now I kind of want to finesse everything a little bit. So I'm cleaning the brush I just used. I'm going to wiggle a little bit on the edges. Then I am going to go to the shade called Rockhopper. I'm going to grab that shade Astro, the blue, just on a small brush for the center. I'm just tapping and then I'm tapping over with my finger because I want kind of that hint of blue there. Without it turning blue, right? Yes. I'm going to tap very lightly in the shade Astro. Okay, it's more of a dark teal, but that's okay. I love my dark teal pencil. Yeah, I think this one is pretty. So this one is from NYX. The other one was from Kiko. I'm going to go to the shade You're My Only Hope and I'm going to press that on top. That's it for the eye look so far. I'm going to clean everything up and make myself a little bit more presentable, because now I kind of look like I've been punched in the face, but that's okay. I'm going to finesse everything and then I will be back to show you the final look. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Everything is on, here is the final look. Falsies I have on are from Primark in the style Paris, and the lippy is from DJ's Unique Boutique. It is a gloss in the shade Purple Unicorn. I thought it would kind of add a little bit of, I don't know, something extra. So, yeah, I really like how the look turned out. And yeah, these types of looks are always trust the process. Because there's always a point that I'm like, this is never going to come together. And it always does. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of this look. And let's get ready for the last one. Look number three is going to be row number three. It's not going to be too complicated because I have two mattes. So the first color I'm going to start with is a color called Seamus. I actually don't really know how to pronounce this. It looks a little bit more vibrant in real life though. So I don't know why it looks flattish on camera, but it does. I know that Angelica really loves the combination of peach and red. And I agree, I do too. At least now that I've tried it a few times. Oh, I'm so excited. Tomorrow I'm getting two new tattoos and this video is pre-filmed. I don't exactly know when it's going online. So it could very well be that you guys have already seen it. But basically, I'm getting a bumblebee here and a blackwork rose there. That's why I actually don't really have the time to film this today. But I really do want to, because I don't know if I have time to film tomorrow, you know? I want that peach underneath my eye too. I think I'm grabbing a red eye pencil. Yeah, I know I'm grabbing a red eye pencil. This is technically not an eye pencil, but a lip pencil that I use as an eye pencil. It's one from Catrice. And they work beautifully in the waterline as well. I'm going to go to the red shade next, called Red Giant. I can show you, but it's just a red matte. And I'm going to press it on top. And I'm also going to extend my lid up. Basically make a wing with it. Are they even? Not really, because they never are. I want to be a little bit graphic with this red, I think. But not too far in. Okay, then I'm cleaning the brush and I'm dragging it forward a little bit in the crease to give it a little bit of definition and to make sure that that line doesn't stop suddenly. Just very lightly blending it. I don't really care about the lid part, but I'm going to put shimmers anyway. Don't want to blend it up. I kind of wanted to blend it in a bit. Yes, okay. Why am I itchy? I don't know. I'm going to go to the shade Nebula because I want that on the lid. And then I'm going to put this one in the inner corner. And then this one in the inner corner. Or maybe even underneath the brow bone. I haven't decided yet. But first I want that shade Nebula. And then here on the outer corner I'm just very lightly tapping. Okay, I'm going to go to the shade Celestial. Which is also very pretty as a face highlight, or at least for me it is. Okay, and then the shade Nova, which is that white, for the inner corner that I will probably have to redo when I do my foundation, but then you can at least see what I did. This is it so far. I'm going to finesse everything, clean everything up, put on my foundation and such, and then I will be back to show you the finished look. Everything is on. Here's the completed look. I like it. I like it a lot. The falsies I have on are from Essence. The Lash Like a Boss. Falsies in the style Oh My God. Maybe they are even my new favorite. Lippy I have on is from Catrice. It is one of their Matte Ink Pro lipsticks in the shade Trust in Me, which is, I don't know the color, but I think it complements the look very, very well. This was it. These were all three looks. Let me know if you have a favorite. Do I have a favorite? I don't think so. I liked them all. I said I wouldn't do a review, and I'm not really going to do a review because I bought the palette first off because I loved the color story, and second because I wanted to support Angelica, and I'm so, so very happy that I did because I really, really like this palette. I like the way that it looks completely. I like the outside. I like the layout. I like the color story. I like the quality. I think this is the best eyeshadow formula that I have from them. Granted, I only have four palettes. So I have this one, and I have the Sci-Fi. The Sci-Fi Green, the VR Neon, and the Turquoise one. Yeah, I really, really like this formula. The dark mattes are very good. The shimmers are gorgeous. Guys, I know that they are going to restock it at least once in March. I hope you can get it if you want it. If you don't want it, then don't get it. I think it's worth its money, not gonna lie. So yeah, that is going to be it for me today. Let me know down below if you have the palette, if you want the palette. Maybe I gave you some inspiration, or maybe you don't have the palette, but you can kind of dupe it out, you know? Let me know down below in the comment section. Is that it? Yes. I have to go now because I'm going to go for a walk outside and be fabulous about it. As per usual. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys. Thank you.